Welcome to Faerun and Baldur's Gate. Spend some time with my dark perch drow Invictus. Thank you to Larian and Baldur's Gate and Sandbox Strategies for our early access to the game pre-launch. And sit back, enjoy, and let's see what happens to our not-quite-right drow. Welcome to the new character creator. Let's make our Tav. Although I don't quite stay with Tav, as you will see. So sit back, enjoy the all new character creator, and see what I come up with.
Promise not to bite until we've been formally introduced. My name's Astarian, and I've spent a century stalking the night, hunting for pretty morsels just like you. A man called Cazador made me what I am, kept me like a pet, forced me to do his bidding. No more. The Tapel's influence broke his dominance over me, and now I can finally pursue the one thing I've hungered for these long, dark years. Revenge. I'm going back to Baldur's Gate to track Cazador down in his lair. I'll be the last thing the bastard ever sees.
Thank you. to next?
What was that?
Let's hope the locals are friendly. Hells, something just woke up down here.
Be wary.
It's opened.
More of those wretched things. There's magic keeping this chest sealed.
Where to next?
Thank you.
Remarkable. Truly.
The blood in your head thrums and pounds. That pounding blood obscures who you are. An overwhelming loss of memory. How you ended up amidst these hellish flames is just as hidden. You have nothing in your skull, besides your name and a headache. But you are in danger. Dark urge. Whatever that is you. You will claw back the truth. But first, you have to claw your way out of here.
Oh, my head.
No traps, please.
Dead. Good.
Of a nautiloid flashes into your mind. Nerves, sinews, as much living being as ship.
You're trapped. Help us.
Yes, you've come to save us from this place. From this place, you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You know no creature like this. One that is more brain than person.
Remove us.
From this body!
From this case. Free us.
An opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat. Your fingers twitch with the desire to rip its tender, moist meat to shreds. Pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
We must go to the helm.
At the helm,
we are needed. To the helm we go.
We are going to the helm.
Thank you. visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
My head. What is this? Squall. You are no thrall. Flakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. You prove surprisingly adequate. Now, to the helm.
What's inside?
A room, but for what?
console appears dormant. The console hums to life. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. A parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. Biomechanical brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated.
Damn thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a gift with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point. Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment.
Finally. Let us make for the helm. We've wasted enough time already.
She's right. Lead on.
We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kanyank. With the Gate after we escape.
Connect the nerves.
Nerves!
We will connect them.
This thing's falling fast. Got to right it. What should I do?
Some bloody work.
Swift and lethal.
time to waste.
Before they strike.
You've made it in time.
Thank you.
half expected your memories to return once you were free of the Mind Flayership. But your past is still an aching void. If you don't find a way to remove the tadpole burrowed in your brain soon, your future will be as blank as your past. Your head whispers vengeance. You cannot wait to slice your way forth, seeking whatever wrought this tragedy upon you. In the pungent corpse. Since you awoke on the ship, your mind has been cold and empty, but something stirs. With your hands close to this body, you know nothing of why, but you find a half smile flittering across your face. This feels like home. There is something unknown and unspeakable deep within your heart.
What's up for discussion?
Alive. How is this possible? I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Time to press ahead.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby. Nothing.
Don't get that open easily. Maybe there's another entrance.
Tools will do the trick.
More of those wretched things.
Vicious filth. Best keep some distance, or this will be a short fight. Time to deal some punishment.
Sometimes the only way out is through. Still on my feet.
As you can see, that didn't quite go as expected, so let's try to recruit Shadowheart properly this time.
Stay back.
strike could be lethal.
Yeah.
You fight well. Perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect. What's next? To keep moving.
Let's get going. Moving ahead.
This time, we're finally getting our favorite noble, snarky, white-haired vampire, Astarion. He's a sneaky fellow, but I'm sure you know that already.
There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it? Not a sound. Not if you want to keep that darling neck of yours. And you, keep your distance. No need for this to get messy.
I need them alive. Stow that blade, or I'll show you just how messy things can get.
Promises, promises. But I have other business, I'm afraid. Now, I saw you on the ship. Didn't I? Nod? You wretched little...
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on?
The worm. Of course. That explains things somewhat. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. A pleasure. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Ha! Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
As he joins your side, your mind dances with thoughts of a perfect, pretty corpse.
Watch your back.
Mind flayer, and it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Just be careful.
With pleasure.
Monster! Death is too good for it.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. If not over, then through.
We're about to meet Gail, and doing so is a dark urge. There will be a take two for this, but sit back, mind the dismembered appendages, and enjoy Invictus showing us a bit of that dark urge.
Anyone? Just your average traveler stuck between realms. Pull me out, and we'll get properly introduced.
This branch of flesh is begging to be pruned, and its sap supped from.
My mistress eyelids, stop! Cease, you loon!
As soon as the dreams cross the threshold of your imagination, you snap back to realize they have all come true.
Just full of surprises, aren't you?
Joy floods through you. You were dazed on the Nautiloid, but now you are truly awake. Alive.
Huh. You look rabid. Pained. Sick. You're spasming and twitching. You poor thing. So far, my tadpole and I have been nothing but best friends. Something else is happening to you, isn't it? You have bouts of swooning and swaying, and your jaw is grinding like you're poised to chew off your tongue. Do take care of yourself. Oh, what's to tell? I'm a magistrate back in the city. It's all rather tedious.
We couldn't actually do that to poor Gale, now could we? I do like the mage, even if he is a bit ridiculous. But this time around, we'll recruit him and do it the right way.
Death is too good for it.
Took the edge off.
Dead goblins over there.
What's going on?
Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
Looks.
Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
Anyone? That's it! Go on! Keep pulling!
Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well.
Then I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region. The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided.
You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you?
A doctor?
Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle.
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them.
As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction.
We're most certainly going to need a healer.
And soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together?
Most excellent! A parasite shared is a parasite halved. Or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you. For pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Either we act now, or someone else will pick that wreck clean and leave us nothing!
haven't seen anyone but us. It's just wilderness out here.
To let up. Moving. Can't attack what can't be seen.
Pawn to cleric 4.
For the ages.
With haste. Minds their business, I'll be fine. On the way.
Need to act fast.
Inside. What path lies before me?
Especially after all that adventuring. Invictus and company can use a little bit of rest. So, let's see what happens in camp the first night with the whole party.
Still breathing.
And next time, I'll join you. Well, after camp, perhaps even on the way to the goblins, that will ever, ever so seriously.
I've heard you can't get blood from a stone, but apparently you can get a wizard from one.
Attention.
Gale seems.
See you later on launch day. Thank you and have a good day.
I understand why you ask, but memory loss is not as uncommon as you'd think. There may be other causes. Interesting. You're hardly alone. Bloodletting is quite popular of late. Though your twinge of conscience sets you apart from the brigands, monsters, and kill-happy fiends of the world. Whatever you think may be compelling you, you may have greater ability to resist it than you realize. Everyone has unseemly thoughts. Being able to quieten them is what sets us apart from the beasts.
We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly?
Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know what to do, so let's do it. Find a way to rid ourselves of these things. We've no solid leads right now, though. We'd best get hunting.
If you discover anything that might help us, I'm all ears.
So, we've picked up a wizard who managed to get stuck in his own portal. Hardly a promising introduction.
Oh, what's to tell? I'm a magistrate back in the city. It's all rather tedious.
First in magic, are you?
Oh, I do apologize. I meant to ask, are you studied in magic? Namely, are you a wizard? Which you are not. If you meet any elder wizards, let me know. There is a matter I'd like to seek advice on from a master. Go to hell. Ha! You're a good sport. Go to hell. An everyday expression. So trivial, it's almost meaningless. But we've seen hell. It's real. And it isn't trivial. Merely contemplating. Devils, dragons, mind flayers. They used to be abstracts. Pictures on a piece of paper. What a difference a day makes. Now we have tadpoles slithering through our heads like carnivorous foeti. That's not abstract. Point well made. I see. I'll wake you bright and early. We'll need to find a healer before the wee one gets hungry.
Your magician seems dour tonight. Must not relish the idea of sprouting tentacles. Understandable. can't say I'm a fan either. It's just hard to join in when all of this feels so new. The night normally means bustling streets, bursting taverns. Curling up in the dirt and resting is, a little novel. I'm in no place to rest yet. Today has been a lot. I need some time to think things through. To process this. You sleep. I'll keep watch. The pleasure is all mine. Sweet dreams.
Doing the rounds, are you? You'd better get some rest. What were you two talking about? You and Gail. Fine. Just don't expect my confidence if I don't have yours. And just to be clear, come daybreak, finding a healer is our first priority. Good. We might even get lucky and find one right away. As I see it, we're overdue some good fortune. Rest well.
With sickly dreams, a deep dread floods you. Though you have a tadpole, you know your broken mind is not like the others who bear the worm. A few scraps of the past come back to you now and then, but you can never quite tell where the knowledge comes from. Inexplicable, violent yearnings overwhelm all other thoughts. Who could you possibly be to be their vessel? Waking up, hearing the pounding war drum of blood. How much you treasured the sight of the first corpse you touched. Instinct tells you you must protect yourself from you. Discover yourself before it is too late. As you fall asleep, you are a shivering and shaking mess. Blood, 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 blood.
You look rabid, pained, sick. You're spasming and twitching. The poor thing. Well, so far, my tadpole and I have been nothing but best friends. Something else is happening to you, isn't it? You have bouts of swooning and swaying, and your jaw is grinding like you're poised to chew off your tongue. Do take care of yourself.
What do you give a book? Everything all right out there?
I told him it wasn't safe out there. Get inside and I'll rustle up some bandages.